In this packet, we will explore maximum and minimum values. Absolute maximum is the highest y value of a function in its domain. Absolute minimum is the lowest y value of a function in its domain. Local maximum of a function is where f of c is greater than or equal to f of x when x is near a value c. Local minimum is where f of c is less than or equal to f of x when x is near a value c. Let's point out some local maximum and minimums. This is where we have absolute minimum, since lowest y value in the domain of the function. Here is the absolute maximum of the function, since it's the highest y value in the domain. Here is a local minimum value. A local max value, and a local minimum value. Local maximum here. More examples identifying extreme values. A nice theorem we use is Fermat's theorem, which says we can find possible local max or mins by finding where f prime of x is 0. Now we do some examples finding critical numbers or values. So we find the derivative using the power rule along with the chain rule here. Now we have the derivative of the function. We can find the critical numbers by looking where f prime of x is 0 or f prime of x is undefined. X can't be negative 2 since it is not in the domain, so our critical numbers are x equals negative 1 or x equals 1. Now let's see what our values are when we plug in our critical numbers. next example. Similar process. We want to find critical numbers, so we take the derivative of the function. Then we find where g prime of t is 0, or g prime of t is undefined. So here we have our two critical numbers at t equals 0 and t equals 1/4. Now let's play with examples of finding local maxima and minima on a closed interval. Example A, makes sense to find the derivative and find critical numbers. In this example, there are no values where the derivative is undefined. So we find critical numbers at x equals 1/3 and x equals negative 1. Now we plug them in to see what their corresponding y values are. We also need to plug in endpoints here so we can see if we have an absolute max or minimum value. Now we can identify our local max and min along with our absolute max and min values. We can see this on the graph as well. Another example. Find critical numbers by finding g prime of x. No undefined values for the derivative function. At this point, we want to know sine of what angle will give us negative 1/2. So we can go to the side here and look at the unit circle graph from 0 to pi. So we start by drawing the triangles where sine is negative. Which is in quadrant 3 and 4. So we have two critical values from 0 to pi, x equals 7 pi over 12, and x equals 11 pi over 12. Now we plug in endpoints and critical values to identify local max, min, and absolute max and min. Now we can identify our extrema. Also, we can see these values on the corresponding graph.